Please stand.
I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Thank you.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Then Peter stood up with the 11 and raised his voice and proclaimed, "You who are Jews, indeed all of you staying in Jerusalem, let this be known to you and listen to my words. You who are Israelites, hear these words. Jesus the Nazarene was a man commended to you by God with mighty deeds, wonders, and signs which God worked through him in your midst, as you yourselves know. This man, delivered up by the set plan and foreknowledge of God, you killed, using lawless men to crucify him. But God raised him up, releasing him from the throes of death, because it was impossible for him to be held by it. For David says of him, 'I saw the Lord ever before me. With him at my right hand, I shall not be disturbed. Therefore my heart has been glad, and my tongue has exulted. My flesh too will dwell in hope, because you will not abandon my soul to the nether world, nor will you suffer your Holy One to see corruption. You have made known to me the paths of life. You will fill me with joy in your presence. My brothers, one can confidently say to you about the patriarch David that he died and was buried, and his tomb is in our midst to this day. But since he was a prophet and knew that God had sworn an oath to him that he would one day set one of his descendants upon his throne, he foresaw and spoke of the resurrection of Christ, that neither was he abandoned to the netherworld, nor did his flesh see corruption. God raised this Jesus. Of this we are all witnesses. Exalted at the right hand of God, he received the promise of the Holy Spirit from the Father and poured him forth, as you see and hear. The word of the Lord. A reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, if you invoke as Father him who judges impartially, yourselves with reverence during the time of your sojourning, realizing that you were ransomed from your feudal conduct, handed on by your ancestors, not with perishable things like silver or gold, but with the precious blood of Christ, as of spotless, unblemished lamb. He was known before the foundation of the world, but revealed in the final time for you. Through him, who through him believed in God, who raised him from the dead and gave him glory, so that your faith and hope are in God. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you.
That very day, the first day of the week, two of Jesus' disciples were going to the village 7 miles from Jerusalem, called Emmaus, and they were conversing about all the things that had occurred. And it happened that while they were conversing and debating, Jesus himself drew near and walked with them, but their eyes were prevented from recognizing him. He asked them, "What are you discussing as you walk along?" They stopped, looking downcast. One of them, named Cleopas, said to him in reply, "Are you the only visitor to Jerusalem who does not know of the things that have taken place there in these days?" And he replied to them, "What sort of things?" They said to him, "The things that happened to Jesus the Nazarene, who was a prophet, mighty in deed and work before God and all the people, how our chief priests and rulers both handed him over to a sentence of death and crucified him. But we were hoping that he would be the one to redeem Israel. And besides all this, it is now the third day since this took place. Some women from our group, however, have astounded us. They were at the tomb early in the morning and did not find his body. They came back and reported that they had indeed seen a vision of angels who announced that he was alive. Then some of those with us went to the tomb and found things just as the women had described, but him they did not see. And he said to them, "Oh, how foolish you are, how slow of heart to believe all that the prophets spoke. Was it not necessary that the Christ should suffer these things and enter into his glory?" Then, beginning with Moses and all the prophets, he interpreted to them what referred to him in all the scriptures. As they approached the village to which they were going, he gave the impression that he was going on farther. But they urged him, "Stay with us, for it is nearly evening, and the day is almost over." So he went in and stayed with them. And it happened that while he was with them at table, he took bread, said the blessing, broke it, and gave it to them. With that, their eyes were opened, and they recognized him, but he vanished from their sight. Then they said to each other, "Were not our hearts burning within us while he spoke to us of the way and opened the scriptures to us?" So they set out at once and returned to Jerusalem, where they found gathered together the 11 with those and those with them who were saying, "The Lord has truly been raised and has appeared to Simon." Then the two recounted what had taken place on the way and how he was made known to them in the breaking of the bread. The Gospel of the Lord. Today we have the passage of the disciples of Emmaus, and the Gospel describes how sometimes we may have false expectations about God. It says from at the beginning, it describes how the disciples were like sad, frustrated. They couldn't understand. They couldn't take the topic out of their minds. They were talking on the way. And when Jesus talked to them, they looked downcast, with their face down. Jesus, when he appeared to them, he acted as if he knew nothing of the events, as an ordinary traveler. The same would happen with Mary Magdalene. He would appear as a gardener. "Woman, whom are you looking for?" Or, "What happened? What events in Jerusalem?" As if he knew nothing. They did not recognize Jesus because two things. What they saw of him depended on Jesus' willingness to reveal himself, and also in the disposition of the disciples' hearts. In the answer from the disciples, when the disciples say, "We hope he were the one to redeem Israel." So think about this. This is important. We hope that he would be the one to redeem Israel. Now I ask you, did Jesus redeem Israel? Yes. The Passion, Death, and Resurrection, he redeemed Israel. But they were expecting something different, a temporal kingdom. Sometimes said, "Oh, how foolish you are, slow of heart to believe." Because he redeemed Israel. And they say, "Behold, he were the one to redeem." How slow of heart to believe. That expression from Jesus is full of feelings. Was it not necessary that the Christ should suffer in order to enter into his glory? Then, beginning with the prophets, he explained everything. How slow to believe. As the story unfolds, it became clear that what blinded their eyes was their unbelief. Now, as they approached the village, Jesus intentionally gave the impression to go on farther, and they looked at him and said, "Stay with us, Lord, for it is nearly evening, and the day is almost over." Stay with us is "Mane nobiscum Domine" in Latin. It's a beautiful song. "Lord, stay with us. Darkness is coming, shadows, and temptations, tribulations will be coming our way. Stay with us." And Jesus entering, took the bread, broke it, and gave it to them, and their eyes were opened. They recognized him in the breaking of the bread. The Eucharist is the Passover dinner, the Passover sacrament, but the sacrament of resurrection, because it's the flesh of somebody that had died but is now risen from the dead. It's a flesh of somebody already risen. That's why it is called pledge of immortality. Pledge of immortality. Pledge of our future resurrection. Whoever eats the flesh, I will raise him up. It's a pledge that we will be risen, because that flesh had already undergone death and is no longer dead, is alive, risen from the dead. And that gives us the assurance of our future resurrection. Let us ask our Blessed Mother to increase our faith in the Eucharist, the pledge of our future resurrection. Please stand. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit he was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he He was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We present before God, our Father, our petitions.
For Pope Francis, Bishop Edward, Bishop Gregory, all clergy and religious, as they help us to grow in faith through the miracle of the Eucharist, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For leaders of nations, that they uphold the dignity of life and enact laws that protect the unborn, the elderly, and the infirm. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For an increase in vocations to the priesthood and the consecrated life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who are ill, may the risen Christ, the divine physician, give them healing and peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For healthcare professionals who care for the sick, that the Lord protect them from the illnesses they are treating and make them instruments of his healing. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who have died, especially victims of the coronavirus and of the recent tornadoes, that the Lord grant them eternal rest and consolation to their loved ones. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Please be seated.
Thank you.
that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exultant church, and as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, only at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this time above all, to love you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying he has destroyed our death, and by rising restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Safe from all distress, as
God, Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I give you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Thank you.
Jesus, I believe that you are truly present in the sacrament of the Eucharist. And I ask you to come to my soul in this spiritual communion that the people from their houses are following us. May you come to their hearts and souls and bring peace to their families. And this grace we ask through the intercession of our Blessed Mother. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Let us pray. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those you were pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection. Through Christ our Lord. Please be seated for announcements.
Please continue following our daily Mass on our Facebook page, SBD at sbdallas.org, and on your YouTube channel. We do not have news yet as to when we will be reopening the church for public masses. As soon as we know, we will let you know. If you need a priest for an emergency, you can call Father Gaston at his cell number 214-684-7880 or Father Luis at his cell 301-793-7531. Confessions are by appointment only. The church is open during the day for people to pray, but when we are celebrating the Mass, we need to close it only for that time. Please, please remember to continue your parish contributions, either online by going to our website, www.sbdallas.org, and press Giving, or by mailing your envelope to the office. This is really essential. Thank you.
Well, thank you so much. This week we have a finance board meeting, and English Pastoral Council and Spanish Pastoral Council, 3 meetings, and all of them through internet. So we are keeping on track with the activities of the parish as much as we can. Okay? So please keep praying and be safe at home. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go forth, the Mass is ended.